everyone. Welcome to my channel, Bianca Scogan Beauty. I am so glad to have you guys here. Today, I have an empties video. I am showing you what I've used up since I did my last empties video. I don't do these on a schedule like every 3 months or something. I do it when my little container of it that I keep my empties in gets full. And then I'm like, oh, it's time for a video. It's full. So I'm going to tell you in here what I think is worth it and what I think is not worth it, because I think it's interesting. Through this channel, I've been talking about stuff that I want, stuff that, especially in this 2023 no-buy year, things that I want and I'm trying not to buy. I think it is interesting for you guys to actually get to see what I'm using up, you know, what I used all the way through and whether I thought it was worth it or not. And if I've repurchased it or would repurchase it. Anyways, that is what this is about. I'm doing a little pre-filming because I can and because I work full time. And so I think this video will go up in December, and I'm fall out right now. Like, isn't that the cutest? There's pies on it. Pies. I got that from Michael's. So cute. Anyways. So I think you'll be like, why do you not have Christmas up? I'm when this video is up, my Christmas will actually be up, but this is a pre-filming. So cool. Anyways, also on my eyes, because I have a really like kind of glamorous eye look on, it is the palette, the Pixie Grove palette from It's Belle Cosmetics. It's a really pretty palette. It's a fall palette. My husband bought it for me this year because it came out this year and he bought it for me. So I was really excited to get it. Let's talk about some empties here. There are three of these Way. Oh wait, no, that's a sea spray. Okay, two. There's two of these Way leave-in conditioners. Okay, so I just filmed before this video my FabFitFun unboxing, and I picked up, because they had this Way leave-in conditioner spray in the FabFitFun box, and I picked up five of them because you can see I use them. Was it 3 months ago that I did my last of this and I went through these? I have a lot of hair. I have so much hair. It's really thick. Right now it's straight iron, so it doesn't look as thick. It's really thick. And so I went through two of these. And yes, they are purple because I have these little drops that I can put in that I can tone things and I make them purple. So right now I have one right now that is purple, and it's actually kind of a jumbo size. It was expensive. Anyways, which is why I picked them up from FabFitFun, because they were much cheaper. So is this a product that is worth the money? Yes. This is a $30 leave-in conditioner. Do I know the price of everything? No, I only know this because it was just in my FabFitFun. This is an expensive leave-in conditioner, but it is the best leave-in conditioner I have ever used in my entire life. I've used other ones and it's like still like getting through the tangles. This one is luxurious and it smells good. And I've actually had the one that was a different smell, Mojave Ghost. I didn't like that. I just didn't like the Mojave Ghost smell. And I blind bought it. I bought it without smelling it, and I was like, because everybody was talking about it, and I was like, oh, the Mojave Ghost is so good. No, I just like the normal smell better. So, two of these. And then there was this one, the Wave Spray. This is, oh, there's hair on it. Cute. This is a Wave Spray. When I was in Hawaii this year, I used this every day in Hawaii, and just because it was so easy. When Hawaii is very humid, and my hair is wavy, and it doesn't want to go super curly, and it doesn't want to go super straight without a straight iron. It was perfect for Hawaii because I just sprayed this in, because I didn't want to do my hair. I was in Hawaii. I was having fun. I was playing with my kids. I was enjoying Hawaii, and I didn't want to be doing my hair every day because then it would go out in the humidity and it would just go poof. So I put this in my hair every day. And actually there was this random lady. We were at the grocery store and she was like, I love your hair. And I was like, thank you. Compliments from strangers are the best compliments, because you know they don't have to do that. And they're just, I like to compliment strangers too, because I like to get them. Anyways, this is a great wave spray. I right now actually have one. I have a wave spray from Briogeo. Okay, here's the thing. This wave spray smells better. This one smells like the wave spray, and it smells good, but this one smells like banana coconut. But I hate the applicator. Like it's more of a pump instead of a spray. And I like the spray, and I'm contemplating switching out the lids so it will. I don't know if it'll work, because I don't know if the consistency is the same, but anyways, I would repurchase that. I kind of did. Like, I got another wave spray. I like a wave spray. It's for my wavy hair. It gives me just like kind of mermaid locks. And so yes, would I repurchase that? Yes, I would. The next hair product that I go through a lot, Olaplex. There's certain brands that I love from high-end brands. Yes, yes they are. But do I get them for a discount usually? Yeah, I usually get them from Fab for Fun for a discount. I don't get Ipsy anymore, but I used to, and I could get them sometimes through there, or I get them through Ulta for a discount. I usually try to get these through a discount, but Olaplex. Olaplex number four, purple shampoo. Olaplex number four, purple shampoo. I also have this big purple shampoo. This is not Olaplex. This I got from Sally's. Okay, this is the Eva NYC. Do I use a lot of purple shampoo? Yes. Yes, I do. Because I have blonde hair, and especially on the ends, I like that toned look. I like it being like kind of silvery, purpley. I think it just looks really pretty. It's not as silver right now, but anyways. So I like to use, I feel like this Olaplex is so concentrated that I can put it on my hair and not have to, like with this one, okay. Are you supposed to leave purple shampoo on for like 2 minutes and then wash it off? Yes. Don't do what I do. Okay, cool. I leave it on for like half an hour because I love that toned silvery purple look to it. So is that good for your hair? No, it dries out your hair, which is probably why I have to use so much Olaplex. This one is just not as concentrated, and this one is, and Olaplex purple shampoo is my favorite, and I've gotten these from FabFitFun. I think I have like a year supply now. Like I have like 10 of these because I got them from FabFitFun during one of their boxes, and then they had an add-on sale, and so I got some more for like, I don't know, like 12 bucks. And these are $30 shampoo, so yay! So I will not be rebuying this. I will be rebuying this. As for the Olaplex purple shampoo, it is very concentrated. If you don't want a purple tint to your hair afterwards, be careful. Leave it on for what is it recommend? 1 to 3 minutes. 1 to 3 minutes, do that. Just do the instructions, don't do what I do. If you want a purple tone, you heard what I said. Oh, I found another purple thing. Oh man. Amika, this is a Bust Your Brass Intense Repair Mask. I think I got this from Sephora during a, like, I think it was on sale. I think it was, and I was like, ooh, cause I was going through some time. This is why I'm a shopaholic. Before I was on this no buy year, I would just go through the clearance section and be like, hey, that's on clearance. I should get it. I love sales. I have a problem, which is thus the no buy year. Anyways, this is okay. It is nice because, as I was saying before, the purple shampoo dries out your hair. You're not supposed to use it every time. You're not supposed to leave it on for too long because it dries out your hair. So this is nice because it's a conditioning mask. And so you can leave it on. It actually says you can leave it on for longer. I don't know, the wording is real small, but you can leave it on for longer because it's a conditioning mask. Does it tone the way that the Olaplex shampoo does? No, no it doesn't. The Olaplex shampoo is the only shampoo I've found that really tones without me having to leave it on for half an hour. I can leave it on for 10 minutes and it tones my hair instead of half an hour. This is good. It's nice to have a conditioner toner, but I think this was expensive even on sale. So I would not repurchase this unless it was like half off. Okay. Olaplex, more Olaplex stuff, yay! We have an Olaplex number four shampoo and number five conditioner. I think I got this in like a set that I bought, and it was just like these like mini sizes because the normal sizes are much bigger. These are little 3 ounce sizes, and this is, you know, 8.5 ounces. So I got this in a set, an Olaplex set that I probably got during Sephora sale. It's funny because this one is not the purple shampoo. And so I would use this one when I wasn't, because you're not supposed to use the purple shampoo every time. And so this one I would use when I was not using the purple one. I would repurchase these. I'm trying to think. Okay. I have actually repurchased, like, so I got a couple of these number fives conditioners. I used the four, and then I have two of the five conditioners that I used up. I have a number three, and this is, I love this. This was obviously the product that got me into Olaplex. This is the first product that was like sold to non-stylists. Like Olaplex 102 is kind of a stylist product. I think they use it while they're like bleaching and such. But number three was the first one that was like sold to the regular public, regular citizens. And I love it for many reasons, because I feel like it is one of those things that I put on my hair and then I felt a difference. I felt like I blow dried my hair and I was like, wow, that's so soft. Like sometimes you're like, oh, and I washed out and I don't feel any lasting effects. It may have actually lasted and helped my hair, but I didn't feel it. I didn't actually touch my hair and feel like it was softer. Olaplex number 3, I love that. It does actually feel softer. And what I like about it is that it's a pre-shampoo. Okay, so I have an obsession with the bath. I love taking a bath. It is my happy place. I get in the bath and I read a book and I put on candles, I put on a face mask, I put in a mask, something like Olaplex, and I am the happiest person in the world. And I'm saying it's like my me time, and it doesn't cost a ton of money like shopping. I do get the things for it, but anyways, I love baths. And I love that this is pre-shampoo, because when I'm in the bath, I don't want to have to shampoo my hair, rinse it out in the bath, then my bath water is all soapy and shampoo-y, and then put this in. Because a lot of masks, you need shampoo first, and then you put in the hair mask, because it's like a deep conditioner, basically. This is pre-shampoo! So, I just get in the bath, get my hair wet, and then I put it in. I put the Olaplex. It's the small things in life, am I right? The small things in life that make you happy, and I love everything about Olaplex number 3. So, cool. I do get a lot of hair stuff. I've gotten them through like subscription boxes. So I feel like I'm just kind of sometimes getting through the ones I got in subscription boxes so I can use my favorite ones like Olaplex. Like this one, this is from Soleil. It ends with an L. I want to say Soleil, but anyways, it is a miracle protecting spray. I don't even know what that is. That's fun. It was in my empties bin. This is something that wasn't completely empty, apparently. I liked this because it's a heat protector. And I use a heat protector. I put it on before I blow dry and straight iron my hair. So heat protector, it was good. Do I know that it actually did anything? It's one of those things where you're like, I think I'm protecting my hair. It tells me I am. It tells me it protects from, I'm surprised it didn't say. Usually it'll be like 450 degrees. It just says use before heat application. Do I know that this really protected my hair? I don't know. Am I giving in to the gimmick that it protects your hair? Probably, but I use a hair protector, a heat protector, because I feel like it helps. So I use that one up. I think I got that one in BoxyCharm, maybe. Anyways, this is from Context. BoxyCharm as well, I think. And that was like before BoxyCharm became Ipsy, and Ipsy, I don't know, whatever. This is a keratin recovery treatment. This is basically a deep conditioner mask. This one is okay. Would I repurchase this? No. No, I wouldn't. I didn't. It was one of those where I'm like, did it do anything? I don't know. I wish I could ask the cells in my hair and ask them if it did anything, because I don't know. Wouldn't repurchase it. If it didn't make a difference for me, I'm not repurchasing. And that heat protector spray, I wouldn't probably repurchase that either, because I have other heat protector sprays that I've gotten through other subscription boxes. Yay! And I just didn't. I don't know. I haven't actually found a heat protector spray that I'm like in love with. I personally love when a leave-in conditioner has also heat protector. And I don't think that the way one I have is all like, it's a double. And that if the only thing that can make that way better is if it was also heat protector, because then it's just another thing I have to add on my hair. I have to put in the conditioner and then a heat protector. And I'm like, really? Am I just weighing down my hair? This is from Sol de Janeiro. I have talked kind of crap about this product in times past. I wanted to get through it. This is the hair repair treatment. It smells amazing. It smells like the Boom Boom cream, but I actually felt like my hair was more tangly after using this. Some people might like it. You know what? It's a possibility that I was using it wrong, because as I've been telling you, there's things that I don't do 100% as the instructions tell me, but I do try the instructions way. Usually I try it first, and if it doesn't work, then I try a different way. So I tried the instructions way on this. I don't know what else there is. You shampoo and then you put this on, right? You leave it in for a couple minutes, and that's how to do it. Where are the instructions? Oh, on the top. Apply to wet hair after shampooing. Evenly coating from root to tip, leave in for 10 minutes, rinse. That's what I did. Okay. And I just felt like my hair was more tangly. So no thanks. I love Sol de Janeiro. I do. Sol de Janeiro. I did One of my best videos on this channel is reviewing the brand Sol de Janeiro because I have a lot of products from them because I love them. I've purchased them with my own money and I was like getting rewards from their rewards program on their Sol de Janeiro website. And I love Sol de Janeiro. The smells are so good. But I didn't like this product. It's not something I would recommend. Maybe it works on some people. It didn't work on me. I didn't like it. Cool. Two products for my curls. When I do my hair curly, when I do it wavy, Curlsmith is my favorite. I went on a journey when I actually started this channel. I did my hair curly, like I didn't put any heat on it for like 8 months because I wanted to do like the curly girl method and like try to see if my hair would get curlier because it's really just wavy. I've tried to get it curly and I did the curly girl method and it did nothing. Honestly, I think the biggest reason is that it's so long. It had so much weight on it that it wasn't, when I cut my hair short, it can be a lot curlier. I'm going like this because I'm scrunching. It's a lot curlier when it's shorter, but I don't want it to be short right now. I want long hair. When I was on that curly girl method, I was getting a lot of curly products because I was getting them from subscription boxes. I was purchasing them. Like FabFitFun does a lot of like add-on sales and they'll have curly hair. They have a lot of hair products. And so I would get them for a good price through that. I was getting a lot of different hair products because that's kind of what they say when you're on that curly girl method is to find what works for you, find which products work for you and then keep going with those. And Curlsmith, I felt like made my hair the curliest. So, and you can get it from Ulta. And so, and I think the first one I got was from FabFitFun. And then I don't think they were on FabFitFun after that. And I was like, sad, but this is the Moisture Memory Reactivator. I have repurchased this many times. This is like my third bottle of it. I really like it because I use it kind of as a conditioner spray, but I can also after a couple of like, I don't wash my hair every day. And after a couple of days, I would put this on and just kind of re-scrunch my hair. And that's the point of it. It's to help with curlies. This is a Bond Curl Rehab Salve. That was a mouthful. And I feel like this was kind of a deep conditioner thing as well. It's not a conditioner. It says that. Curlsmith Curl Rehab Salve is not a conditioner. It's a lightweight, intense treatment that makes hair look stronger. Okay, well, I did whatever it told me to do. I liked them. For curly hair stuff, I would repurchase Curlsmith because I personally think this brand works well for me. So yes, would I repurchase these? Yes. I think I have another one of these in the wings. I'm done with hair. Can you believe that? Finally, I'm done with all my hair empties. I use a lot of hair care products. My hair is, I really like my hair. And so this is all mine, by the way. There's no extensions here. This is all my hair and I take care of it. I baby it because I love it. I feel like my empties videos are always so long. Maybe I should do them more than every, when the bin gets full because, and I talk, I'm a talker. Okay, so let's go through lotions. What lotions did I get through? Another Sol de Janeiro product. I told you I love Sol de Janeiro. I don't think I'm going to recycle this because now they have, oh, this is filthy. I use in the summertime when I use this, I use body oils and stuff. And this is body oil on it. That's fun. This nowadays, this size, I think this is the 8 ounce one. This one has a refill. So you can buy it and just stick it in, you know, clean this out. Obviously I didn't clean it out yet, but you clean it out. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. You clean it out and then you can just put the new one in there. So I don't think I am going to recycle this one. I'm going to reuse this one. Yay, cool. But I got through a whole one of these. It's one of my favorite lotions. I use it in the summertime mostly because it just reminds me of summer. Then I have this lotion from First Aid Beauty. This is the Ultra Repair Cream. This is like a staple that I use, especially during the wintertime. So you're like, how did you get through that during like kind of the summer and the beginning of fall? I don't know, I use it all year round. This one was supposed to have a gingerbread natural infusion. That's why there's this little gingerbread guy on it. And I think I got it during last fall's Sephora sale because it was, or no, or did I get it during an Ulta sale? I think it was originally 20 bucks and I got it for 10. And I was like, $10 for a 2 ounce cream? That's a lot. This barely smelled like gingerbread. I know it says a natural infusion in gingerbread. It was like the most natural. I couldn't smell it, barely at all. So would I repurchase this? I repurchased this cream. I love this cream. The backs of my hands during wintertime always get really dry and painful. And so this stuff is amazing. I love this stuff for the wintertime. Utah winters are extremely dry. I learned when I went to school here in Utah, because I'm actually from Arizona, that Utah is drier than Arizona. And I was like, nah, Arizona's a desert. Utah's a high desert. So it's actually drier here than in Arizona. Shocking. Anyways, so this stuff is amazing. Would I repurchase this? Yes. Would I repurchase the gingerbread? Nah, it didn't do anything. I mean, it didn't smell. So cool. Then this is from Kopari. It is a Ultra Restore Body Butter. Is this a tiny little sample size? Yes. Should I even be putting it in here? I don't know. But I have a hard time getting through samples. You get samples from, like, I did a whole video wearing a whole face of samples because I never use them. They get lost in my collection. You get samples when you order things from Sephora and Ulta, and they just give you tons of samples. And then I put them like in a box in my closet that just has samples in it. And I never use them. So I have been trying to go through my samples more and actually using them, because the point of them is for you to get to try out that product and then be like, do I like this product? Would I buy a full size of this product? And so I was happy to get through this. That's why it's in here, because even though it's a sample size, I used it and it actually lasted a long time. This is the Kopari Ultra Restore Body Butter. This stuff was thick. I was like, this little tiny, what is this? 1.4 fluid ounces. I was like, I'll get through this in one shot. No, this took me like, I put this on after I shower. This took me, I don't know, like 5 times. It was thick. It didn't really have a smell. Yeah, it's pretty much unscented. So if I could find this on sale, because that's what I do, I get things on sale, I would repurchase this. I liked it. I think it was on sale during the 21 Days of Beauty sale, and I just didn't need any more lotions. But, and I've actually heard that it kind of goes off, like it goes bad fast, because what I was saying, it takes forever to get through. So I would, if I were to repurchase, I would buy a small size, maybe not this small. I don't even know if they sell this sample size, but I would buy a small size because I've heard it goes off fast. But it was nice. It was very moisturizing for my skin. And again, I live in the high desert. It is very cold and very dry here. And not in the summer, it's not cold, but anyways, it's dry. And so I usually use like a body oil and a body cream after the shower, because my skin is really dry and it's really sensitive. I have psoriasis and I just have really sensitive dry skin. Cool. Okay. Then I have this from Murad. Okay. I got this from BoxyCharm a long time ago. This took me forever to get through. Forever. So I'm so proud of being done with this. This is the City Skin Overnight Detox Moisturizer. I liked it. I did. I like Murad. I think they're a good brand. I hated the applicator on this. It has a little, but like it got, like the lotion would get dried up and get stuck in there. And so it stopped working. So I actually took, I think I kind of like dismantled it a little bit. I used it up. It took me forever. I'm so proud of being done with that one. Yay. Would I repurchase this? I don't think so. I think I recall this being like $80. And as I said, because I feel like BoxyCharm and Ipsy loved to give face creams. Like it was one of the, like every time I would get one of those boxes, I would get a face cream. And I was like, really? Another face cream? I would not repurchase that because I think it was really expensive and I have like 5 or 6 face lotions in the wings right now because they gave you so many and I like to use what I have. Okay, cool. Lastly, this is from Isle of Paradise. This I was like, do I put this in my lotions? Yes, I do, because this, the way these work, they are the self-tanning drops. You're supposed to mix them in with the lotion. And so that's what I've did. I only self-tan during the summertime. I don't know, I embrace my paleness during the winter time and the fall time, but this is the medium and I was able to go through this entire thing, face and body drops, which I find cool because a lot of people are scared of like tanning their face. Shouldn't use stuff that's just for your body on your face. This one is a face and body. And so I thought it worked really well. I would mix it in with my face lotion. I would mix it in with my body lotion and then I would be tanner the next day. Yes, it's a little finicky. Like if I didn't wash my hands, I would get like brown on my hands, like in my webbing. And I was like, that's fun. Am I webbing? Am I a fish? No, but you know, right here. And so, but it was showing that it was working. So cool. I have some serums here and let's see, we have a little, again, I'm showing you that I got through a sample size because I'm proud of myself for getting through these sample sizes because they end up just sitting. Cause I'm like, I'll use them when I travel. And then I travel one time a year and I forget them. So this was from Peter Thomas Ross. It was the glycolic retinol resurfacing serum. That was a lot. It has 1.5% retinol. That one actually did kind of make my face tingle. I have been using, I use retinol I don't know, daily. And I use like a 1% retinol. And so this one going up to the 1.5, it did make my skin tingle. But it was fine. I didn't like make my skin burn. So would I repurchase this? Maybe. Yeah, I did like it. I felt like with the tingling, I felt like it was doing something. Was it actually doing something? I don't know. But if I could find it for a good price, I would repurchase that one. This, Sunday Riley. This is the high dose retinoid serum, which is funny because this is, says it's a high dose. Oh, it's 6.5. Oh, and this is 1.5. Huh, interesting, because I felt like this tingled more. Anyways, cool. This I think I got this from FabFitFun, or else I wouldn't have been able to afford this because Sunday Riley is a very expensive brand. And I used it up and I liked it. It was good. I like having a specific like nighttime serum and like a daytime serum because the nighttimes like have retinoids and have like actives in them. And so, yeah, I liked this. It was good. Would I repurchase it if it was on sale? Should that be the theme? That is the theme of this video. I would rebuy it if it was on sale. If it was not on sale, no. Because I think it's like an $80 serum. So yeah. Anyways, this one is from Laneige. This is the Glowy Makeup Serum. I got this from TJ Maxx. And I remember there was also from Glow Recipe, there were some drops that were very similar to this. And I remember these both came out at like the same time. And I wasn't able to find the Glow Recipe ones at TJ Maxx, but I found these at TJ Maxx. I ended up not liking the Glow Recipe ones. I think I was very in the minority for that one. I most people like those, but I didn't like the little like plunger system. I just didn't feel like it worked very well. And this one has a little dropper. And I just thought that that was a good system for getting this out. And I was able to get out like every drop of it. And I liked it. I liked it. It is a makeup serum. So I kind of like that because I was talking about I would have a nighttime serum and a daytime serum. Here you go. Daytime before makeup. Nighttime when I took all my makeup off and was ready to go to bed. Would I repurchase this one? Yeah, I actually probably would. Even not on sale. Once I get through all the other serums I have. I would rather buy it on sale though. Okay, I have some face masks. So I told you guys that I love the bath. And when I'm in the bath, I use a face mask because it's like, you know, my pampering time. I pamper me. And I have some face masks that I put on when I'm in the bath. So this one is from Glen Glow. Another little size because I am proud of getting through those. This is the Super Mud Clearing Treatment. I like Glam Glow. I feel like they used to be really big. Like everybody would talk about Glam Glow and they're like kind of in their down era where not as many people are talking about them. I thought it was a good mask. This one, I have actually repurchased this one 3 times. I think this is my second one. This is from Urban Skin and it is the Pumpkin Pore Detox and Scrub. Okay, here's the difference between these two. This is from Pure Lease. This one is a pumpkin and ginger charcoal detoxifying mask. They're both like detoxifying masks. They both are supposedly pumpkin. This one barely smelled like pumpkin. And okay, it's fall time. I'm obsessed with pumpkin spice. Yes, I'm very basic and I'm okay with that. It makes me happy, so boom. And I got this one from FabFitFun, I think. And that's also another theme of the video. Did I get it from subscription box? Yeah, but I use them. So that's, it's showing that I use my subscription boxes. I would not repurchase this one. It barely smelled like pumpkin. This one smells like pumpkin spice delight. It's so good. It smells so good. And when you rub it together, it warms up in your palms. It's such a fun mask. I really like it. So does it, it says it smooths, clarifies, and improves the appearance of pore size. Does it do that? I don't know. It makes my skin feel cleaner afterwards and it smells like pumpkin spice. And I got this. This is one of those things on Ulta that will go half off every once in a while. So I buy it. I'm almost hitting myself in the face. I buy it every time it's half off. I love it. So good. I have some cleansers here. Kind of. This is not really, this is a body wash. This is from Bath & Body Works. It is the Pink Pineapple Sunrise. This one, it's funny. I think I dropped it and I broke the lid. Ugh. I broke the lid. So actually get, and I think I broke it like right when I got it. So getting through this, look, this body wash was a pain in my neck because I always had to, oh my gosh, it is filthy. I always had to like hold the lid on as I was like pouring it out of my loofah, but pineapple. I have a couple scents that are like my favorite scents in the whole wide world. Pineapple, lavender, pumpkin. Pumpkin obviously during this time of year, pineapple during summertime, and lavender all the rest of the year. So those are the smells that I would They're my favorite, obviously. And this is pineapple, and it smelled great, and I loved it. It was great, except for that I broke it. So anyways, would I repurchase this? Yes. Yes, I would. Was it like the best, like, actually, I don't think it was very moisturizing. Like, I don't think it claims that. Does it claim that? It says it's aloe and vitamin E. I wish it was more of a moisturizing shower gel, but it's Bath & Body Works. You get what you pay for. It's not the most luxurious brand, but I love it. I love the smells. The smells are what do it for me. Pharmacy, Green Clean. When I wash my face, actually, I have two things. This is how I wash my face. I first use an oil-based cleanser. This is the Makeup Melt Away Cleansing Balm. And then after I use that, then I put on a regular cleanser because I just feel like my skin is still oily after the cleansing balm. I don't think you need both, but I just feel like my skin's still oily after this. This is, if I just use one or like, if I just use the regular cleanser, I don't feel like it gets all of like my mascara off. And look at all this makeup I'm wearing. It doesn't get it all off. So this, using a double cleanse method, is perfect. So again, I have another Glam Glow. Did I get this from a subscription box? Yes, I did, but I used it all up, so I'm pretty happy about it. And this one took a long time. Like, sometimes I'll have cleansers and, like, I don't know, they just get used up so long, fast. This one held on for a while, which I was happy about, because I don't have to repurchase. I guess I don't need to repurchase them because I have a lot in the wings right now because of subscription boxes, which is why I canceled Ipsy. Anyways, but would I repurchase these? I definitely would repurchase this one. This is the Pharmacy Green Clean. I love this. This is a great system. This, the Glam Glow, it was okay. It wasn't the best cleanser I've ever had. It says it's a clearing cream to foam cleanser, and I actually have acne on my nose, and I don't feel like it did anything for that. But it was a cleanser. It smelled nice. It kind of was minty. Yeah, it wasn't anything to write home about, though. So yes, repurchase, not repurchase. Maybe if it was on sale, I don't know. And I needed one, which I don't right now. This one's a little weird. I'm showing you this, but I have repurchased this. So this is from First Aid Beauty. It's the ingrown hair pads. Okay, so do I get ingrown hairs? Yes. This helps with getting less ingrown hairs. And I remember, I notice when I forget to use it, I'll get ingrown hairs. Like, does this completely stop from ingrown hairs? No, nothing does that I'm aware of. But when I use this, I am less likely to get an ingrown hair than when I don't. So I've repurchased these. Originally, I think I got this from FabFitFun. I got it in a two pack. It was this and also like something for my KP, my keratosis pilaris, the bumps on my arms. And it came in a two pack. And I thought it was kind of weird because I was like, KP and ingrown hairs, like, do those go together? But anyways, I've used them both up and I loved both of them and I will repurchase both of them. Great. We are on to makeup. We are finally on to the makeup. I have two products that are, I call them makeup, but they're like less makeup-y. So I'm saying them first because we'll get to the more makeup at the end. This is the Super Goop Unseen Sunscreen. Why do I say this is makeup? Because I use it as a primer. I prime my face with it. It's a sunscreen primer. I like it because the consistency of it is very thin. I think it's very silicone-y from my small amount of knowledge. Yes. Yeah, I think it is. And it just soaks into my skin really well and doesn't leave it feeling greasy. And it wears like a primer really well. So I like it. Would I repurchase it? Yeah. Then I have this from Laneige. I think I have one of these in every single one of my empties videos because it's dry here. It is dry in Utah. And this is it is not my favorite lip mask. Okay. My favorite lip mask is the milk melatonin one. That one is my favorite and you can't get it on Sephora anymore. I think you can still get it from Milk's website, but it's a pricey little guy. And it's my favorite because I'll put it on and I'll wake up and my lips are still moisturized. Even after I slept in. This one, it feels good at the moment, but I wake up and my lips are dry. So these Laneige ones are nice. Would I repurchase it? Yes, actually this Sephora sale, I purchased the sampler pack that had like five of them for $20 because I was like, this is the berry kind. And I was like, I would like to try some other kinds because the milk one is expensive and I can never get it on sale. I have a problem. Should I just buy it not on sale? Yeah, probably. Anyways, these are okay. They're not the best in the world, but they're okay. Why did I say this is makeup? Because I got it at Sephora and it's like a makeup skincare brand. I don't know. Some people put it on their lips before they put on makeup. So now we get to the real makeup. I realized that in my last videos, I would just throw away my mascaras. Like, I forgot to put them in these videos. I had mascaras that I went through. I was just, when the mascara was done, when it had been over 3 months and the mascara was done, mascaras are hard for me to trash, because I feel like it's still, like, I could still actually put this on my eyes right now. Would it work very well? Like, it doesn't smell bad. It doesn't, it's still like moisturized. It's still like, it's not hard and crusty. Like, I could still actually put this on my face right now, or my eyelashes, and it would work. So I feel like mascara is one of those things that they tell you you're supposed to throw away after 3 months because it can grow bacteria and you don't want bacteria in your eyes. It's one of those things that is so hard, because did I technically use this up? I don't think so. There's still product in here. I'm not 100% sure, but because I didn't like empty it out, but there's still product in these. In these three that I have. But had it been 3 months or over 3 months? Yes. Yes, it had. And it was time. It was time. It was time to get rid of them. So what I had done before with my old videos, every time I had a mascara and it was time to throw it away, to make myself do it, I just threw it in the trash. And I was like, don't. It's now in the trash, which is a dirty place. You're not going to use it. It's gone. It's gone. Get your mind off of it. Go to a new one. Which I have mascaras. So why am I don't know. I like using things till the very end. So this is from Maybelline Lash Sensational Sky High Mascara. This is from Pure Fully Charged. I think I got this one from an influencer box for free. Anyways, and this one is from Charlotte Tilbury, which I got from a mystery box, I remember. This is the Legendary Lashes. Okay, this one was chunky. It was, every time I got it out of the tube, it was like, I had to wipe off so much mascara. Wouldn't repurchase that. That was chunky. This one was okay. The pure one, nothing to write home about. It's supposed to be magnetized, and so it's magnetize your lashes as you go through. Did I feel like it did that? No, it was nothing to write home about. This one, I felt like people were talking about this one so much. We're like, Maybelline, and people always talk about how drugstore mascaras are better than high-end mascaras. Nah, all three of these were, actually, these two were meh. This one was, I didn't like this one. I had to force myself to finish this one. So I have better mascaras that I like. I like the Thrive mascara. I like, I love Benefit mascaras. I actually, Essence has a good, I've heard that all of their mascaras are not great, but they're, the Green Princess one is really good. There's great mascaras out there. These were nothing that I would not repurchase these. This, my beauty blender. Technically, is this done? Did I empty this? Did I use this up? No, how do you use up a beauty blender? But it has, I don't know how often technically you're supposed to throw these away. It was seeing a lot of wear and tear. Where can I not see it now? It's because it's not floofed up. But there's some gashes in it just from wear and tear, and some like holes in it, and it's really dirty. This is where I put on my blush, obviously, and my foundation. And this is an actual beauty blender, which I don't always have beauty blenders. I just have, you know, beauty sponges. I have one right now. I don't even know what brand this is. So I don't know. Anyways, I used it though. I'm throwing it away because I'm telling myself, Bianca, you have to use this enough. It probably is full of bacteria. And do I clean it? Yes. Every time I clean my brushes, I clean these. So it's not, I don't know if it's full of bacteria. I actually have cut one of these open one time because I had heard people cutting them open and like seeing if there was like bugs inside of them and stuff. And I never had that happen. When I cut it open, it was fine. But it's time. It's time to be done with this because I need to have a clean face. From Huda Beauty, this is the Silk Balm. Technically, is this makeup? Because it's a balm? I don't know, but yes it is. I think it is because it's like a lip gloss balm. I liked this because of that, because it was like a lip gloss, but I felt like it left my lips moisturized. Like, I feel like most lip glosses, they wash off or they wipe off and you still have dry lips. This one left my lips moisturized and I liked it. I got it from a mystery box and it didn't have any color. It's in the shade Blush. It was basically clear. And I used this up to the very last drop. And would I repurchase this? Yeah, I would. I would. I would re-get this from Huda Beauty because I liked it. I thought it was a good balm. ColourPop. This is the Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Acid Setting Mist. This took me forever to use up. I used up, I think there's a tiny little drop in there, but I can't get it. It would be, okay, it would be really hard to get it actually on my face. This smells really good. It smells like coconut. It's a good mist. I liked it. I don't feel like it was really that amazing for what it's supposed to do, setting your makeup, a setting mist. I don't feel like I was like, oh my gosh, my makeup will last all day with this. So it's not something that I'm like, yes, your makeup will last all day, but it's a hyaluronic acid. Like, I felt like it was moisturizing. I felt like it smelled good. I felt like it was a great, for the price, I think it's like $16. I thought it was a good product. I wouldn't probably not repurchase this because I do have other setting sprays in the wings. If I got through them all, no, there's other setting sprays I like better. Like the Charlotte Tilbury setting spray, that one's way good. The Anastasia Beverly Hills one also smells like coconut and it's also kind of moisturizing, but I think it's better. I wouldn't repurchase this one. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't anything to write home about. It wasn't amazing, but it took forever to get through. So it is worth your money. Like, this lasted me like, I don't know, a year and a half. So, and I do my makeup a lot. Not every day, but I do my makeup a lot. Stila. It's just a mini eyeliner. But I wanted to, even if they're mini, I want to show them because I got through them. I actually tried to use this one today and it did that wing. And then on this one, it gave up. It gave up the ghost. So if my wings are a little uneven, that's normal. Wings are hard. But also it might have been this one's fault. It's dead. It has seen better days. It's dead. I actually was storing it like this so that all of the liquid would like go into the tip. It's dead. I used it all up. It's just a little small one, but these Stila eyeliners are really good. Like, Stila is kind of known for their eyeliners and then they're like their glittery eyeshadows, and good. It was a good eyeliner. Would I repurchase it? Yeah. Yeah, I would. Last thing. Finally, am I finally getting this done? My voice is almost gone. Man, finally. I need to do these videos more often. Anyways, this is from Rare Beauty. This is amazing. This is the eye primer. This lasted me so long. The only problem I had with this is that the wand, I guess it does go all the way to the bottom, but like, when it's all the way screwed on, you can't mix it around. It only stirs around to like, can you see? I don't know. You can't really, but it only stirs around to about half of there. And so I was left with about this part that was still product in there. So I purposefully purchased, I think it was from Ulta, this little like spatula mechanism. So I could go in there and scoop out, because this base is so good. I like this base so much that I purchased this spatula to scoop out all as much as I could. So did I use as much of this as I possibly physically could? Yes, I did. It's a good, I think this is like, I don't know, like $16 or something. It's a really great eyeshadow primer. Great. Liked it. Good eyeshadow primer. So much that I purchased a spatula for it, which is a weird, it came with a 2-pack of spatulas and I was hoping that this one would be shaped. This one is too big to go into there. But this one is a much better like shape for scooping. It's more spatula shape. What the heck is this shape? I don't know. It worked okay, but it's a weird shape. Anyways, so there it is. My empties. Yay! My recycling can is going to be full this week. Yay! Anyways, there it is. What did you think? Oh my gosh, I didn't have an AYR gel in here. I always have an AYR gel. I'm actually going through one right now. It'll be in the next one. Anyways, I hope you liked this video. If you did, like this video. If you want to see more videos from me, subscribe to my channel. And if you want to be reminded or if you want to be notified of my videos, push the bell. Most importantly, be nice to yourself because you are amazing. Have a great day. Bye.